Have you ever wondered what makes a great public speaker? What makes a great motivational speaker? I'm going to share some thoughts today, give you some insights, what I think it takes to be a great public speaker. So stick around. Hi, it's a Trigger, Rich Bontrager. Welcome back to another Leaders and Communicators. And today we're going to talk about public speaking, but not just any old lesson or discussion about public speaking. We're going to talk about what it takes to be a great motivational type of public speaker. Now, I've got 25 years as public speaking. I've done it from church ministry as a pastor to motivational speaking and traveling and as a sports broadcaster. I've been around the microphone for 25 years. I've seen a lot. I've learned a lot. And today I want to talk about what it takes to really be great. So as we get into this, if you've never subscribed to my channel before, take a moment and hit that subscribe button. Hit that little bell. And that bell will mean that you get to never miss another one of our talks, discussions here. And they are discussions. I want to hear from you during the discussion. So please, give me a comment in the comment bar below. What do you think makes a great motivational public speaker? There's a lot of different thoughts on what it takes to be great. And some of the things I'm going to share today may not be what you expect. So let's begin the conversation today. The first thing I think that it takes to be a great motivational speaker is you've got to be yourself. There's a lot of people wanting to speak. There's a lot of people that want to get up on the stage for many different reasons. But a lot of people are posers. They're faking it. They're trying to be Tony Robbins. They're trying to be John Maxwell. They're trying to be whoever that person is that they most identify with. But I think the best, the greatest ones are simply themselves. They are just who they are, comfortable in their own skin, and they relate and communicate as if they're just talking to you in everyday, ordinary style. So, the second thing I think that is very important about those great speakers is they are authentic. What I mean by authentic is sometimes things happen on stage that you don't really plan for. You may have a perfect message, everything from start to finish in between. You have all your graphics all ready to go. You have your clicker in your hand for your TED Talk, and things go wrong. The most incredible speakers, the great ones, I think, are able to handle those type of situations and sometimes even admit it. And actually say, you know what, folks, that didn't go as planned. Take two. Let me try that again and tell you what I really meant to say. There's something really marvelous about people that are comfortable just being real about the mistakes. And they invite you into that moment instead of having it be an awkward moment where you're all wondering, what just happened? Why did it happen? Did it really happen? Instead, the authentic speaker takes all that curiosity, all that mystery away, and just continues to go forward and takes you on the journey of, yep, that just happened, and we're still okay. Now, the third thing I think it makes a great motivational speaker is, they've already answered this question that I'm going to put to you right now, and I want to hear your responses to it. I want you to go down to the comment bar and answer this question. Why do you want to be a public motivational speaker? What's your driving purpose? Is it to make big money and be on a lot of stages? And there's nothing wrong with making money. There's nothing wrong with getting out there and doing all you can. But is that why you want to be on stage? Is it that you want to be a motivational speaker to sell more books, to give you more product and more acclaim, to be that rock star on the stage? And there are a lot of people I know, the only reason they're on is they want more press time. Or are you wanting to be a motivational speaker to impact lives, to transform lives, and make a difference in the world? Because I believe the great speakers, the great motivational public speakers, have a passion and a heart to change the world. They want to get on stage and they want to make a difference. And they can't fake it. Their passion lights them up. Their energy drives them to share the message that is burning with inside of them. For me, that happened a long time ago. I had a calling and a passion to be a pastor, to speak the truth of the Bible. Since then, that passion has grown and expanded beyond just the church ministry, but to a larger platform to help people understand how to defy the odds in their life. We all face challenges. We all have hard times. We're not immune to them. And I want to share the message of how you can actually overcome those things and defy the odds and have a great, adventurous, marvelous life. I believe those are some of the things that make great speakers. It's not that they're always polished. It's not that they're always the coolest. It's there's something real and authentic that transcends even what they have on the PowerPoint. And they pull you in. They grab your heart. They capture your imagination with a story, with an illustration that sets you into motion, into action. And it takes you beyond a conference, an event, into an amazing new adventure. Let me hear from you today. What do you think makes a great motivational type of speaker? I'd love to hear your thoughts and comments on what I just shared today. And again, don't forget to give me a like, give me a comment, give me a share, subscribe to this channel as we continue to talk more about leadership, communication, and yes, about defying the odds and overcoming. Until next time, I'm the Trigger, Rich Bontrager. God bless, and we'll see you next time.